Most of these desk drawers haven't been used for so long, I'm afraid to open them. As usual, it's a mess. 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 Another pile of garbage. There just aren't. Well, since the building inspector has only one eye and no depth perception, the hotel manager painted fire extinguishers in all the apartments. It saved him a bundle. I call this painting, The Big Spill. The stupid light switch is stuck in the on position. Could be worse, I guess. All I've ever needed was a soft felt fedora, a well-tailored overcoat, and a comfy pair of sneakers. Some people know what they like and they stay with it. Great-great-grandpa Murphy made it through the Depression by teaching cha-cha lessons to rich older women. He made thousands before the authorities found out he had no formal training. The office was actually a dance studio before I moved in, and Latin. That's the door to the street. The air outside feels thick, like I'm breathing through a pair of dirty gym socks. It's a high radiation day. Most everyone will be staying inside, but I need to hunt for some work. I always like to start the day with the traditional PI breakfast. That hits the spot. Chelsea runs a first. Chelsea Bando's the kind that could hold her own with anyone, but she has a way of turning my knees to jelly. She's a mutant just like everyone else in this part of town, but she's a real beauty.
Well, hello, stranger.
Tell me, gorgeous, has the new True Detective come in yet?
Yeah, Yeah, but you gotta pay for it this time. Hey, when you finish a magazine, it is in no condition to sell.
Sure. Kick me when I'm down. You think it's fun being broke?
Well, you know, Tex, there just might be a job for you. Have you heard that Rook's place got robbed?
No, I didn't. What do you know about it?
Rook acts like a tough guy, but he's a softie. Just don't tell him that to his face. Oh, you know me, Tex. I'm just making ends meet. I love Louis, but his friendliness doesn't fool me. He's a sharp one. He knows everything that's going on in this neighborhood. Franny's a live wire. Either she or Sal is going to do time for killing the other one. I have never seen a couple fight like they do. Sal's a handful. He's a nice guy, but I don't know, I feel kind of naked when he gives me the eye. Luckily, Ardo seems to like me. I mean, if I were on his bad side, I'd be tempted to relocate. He could crush a Subaru with one hand. Wish I could help you there, Tex. Yeah, you know, I remember Rook told me about the burglary. You know, I remember a stranger hanging around the past couple of days. It might be a dead end, but I seem to remember that the guy had these bright green eyes and a tattoo of an anchor on his arm.
Chelsea runs a fur. I like to stand by. Surprisingly, the auto post box has no graffiti on it. Maybe people around here are finally starting to respect our government and its fine agencies. Rook Garner runs this pawn shop. He's a crusty old World War III vet with a face like a raisin and a tongue like a butcher's cleaver.
What do you want, Murphy?
Fine. How you doing, Rook?
I'm not in the mood for small talk.
Fine. What do you want to talk about?
Let me tell you about my great day, Murphy.
Last night, someone broke into my pawn shop. I don't usually have anything of great value, but yesterday, I gave out a fair amount of cash for an extremely valuable diamond bracelet.
How much is a fair amount of cash?
In this case, $8,000.
Boy, that's a lot of clams, Rook.
Don't you think I know that?
The bracelet was pawned by a young girl named Emma Nimpton. She said she hated to hawk a family heirloom, but had no choice. She said she would reclaim the bracelet in a month. Well, since the bracelet was worth 10 times the $8,000 I loaned her, it was a good deal for me.
I think you've been played for a sap, Rook.
Maybe. She left me a number, and I called it this morning, but the line is disconnected.
Sounds like my vast experience as a PI could come in handy.
Yeah, it couldn't hurt. The police are no help. A mutant is on his own when he gets robbed in this town. I'd appreciate your help. I'm not a rich man, but if you find the bracelet, I'll owe you a few favors, which could come in handy. Come back here and I'll show you where they broke in.
Rook takes me out back and shows me where the burglar broke in. The back window is busted out and the latch is ripped. It's a sloppy job. As I start my investigation, I'm looking for information to enter into my crime link computer back at the office. One thing's for sure, Emma Nimpton won't be one of the suspects' names. Every PI worth his salt knows that's not my name spelled backwards. I wonder what all these garbage cans are doing around here. Maybe Rook is running a... The empty bottles of chocolate syrup lying all around this alley all... Reminds me of playing hoops when I was younger, in the days before my lower... These disgusting piles... Whatever's on the other end of this power box must be out of commission. The gate... Garbage cans are doing around here. These disgusting. It's one of those basketballs they used to give away. 10 seconds left. Down by one. Murphy has the ball. He fakes. He drives. It's a 360.
He's fouled.
Every time I see yellow-gray water oozing out of a gutter, I just can't help. These are empty jumbo-sized cans of... The baby rum wrapper looks like it was left recently. Yep, still warm. Another billboard advertising cosmetic surgery. It's big business these days. Mutants with money will pay anything to look like norms. Whoa! This antique boombox worked. I bet it'd only play the Bee Gees. This old relic probably hasn't worked in years. Hey, there are batteries in here. I wonder if these still work. Tingly tongue. Still got juice. Well, I'll be darned. Except for the filth and stench, the interior isn't much different than the average studio apartment. In fact, it's nicely furnished. Someone's been living here, and I wonder if he saw anything. I don't usually enjoy piles of garbage, but they...
Wow, a recyclable paper can. Finally, a glimmer of ecological responsibility. I didn't know Rook cared. An empty bottle of evanescent spring water, for those with a higher class of thirst. It feels like somebody's watching. Someone really weird. Wow, well, I'll be darned. Oh, I would love to see my ex-mother-in-law squeeze through there. All hell has broken loose since the government stopped requiring products to display those give a hoot, don't pollute symbols.
Hi, Tex. How's the investigation? Sorry, I haven't heard anything about that. Yeah, you know, I remember Rook told me about the burglary. You know, I remember a stranger hanging around the past couple of days. It might be a dead end, but I seem to remember that the guy had these bright green eyes and a tattoo of an anchor on his arm.
Bijou Theater used to be quite a night spot. It was condemned years ago and could collapse any day. There's no way I'm going in there. Looks like someone took a pee here. Rusty the Clown's novelty shop. Closed down a few months ago after Rusty mysteriously disappeared. The police suspect foul play, but I think he probably just choked to death on his own bad jokes. It's all locked up. The only way I'm gonna get inside is by using my innate cleverness or ingenuity, or maybe a key. Louis Lament runs the Brew and Stew, which is a local hangout. There are signs of radioactive. Francesca Lucido makes the spiciest pizza in the city. The only thing spicier than her cooking is her imagination. And right now she seems to have a thing for me.
Nothing in here worth taking. The Brew and Stew is run by Louis Laments, a bloated mutant with a heart bigger than his waistline. Everyone comes to Louis' cafe. So does all the street talk. If something's going on, Louis knows about it.
What can I do for you, Mife?
Well, for starters, you could give me a job. I've forgotten what a paycheck looks like.
I hear you, Mife. Last week, I had to lay off half my kitchen help. Times are pretty tough, but it could be worse.
So you haven't heard of any major unsolved crimes in the neighborhood, have you?
Sorry, Mife. But I'll sure let you know if I hear of anything. Rook's an ornery old cuss. But me and him are old buddies. We fought in the big war together. He's one person you can trust in these troubled times. Chelsea acts tough. But she has to be with all the scum around. And she's as smart as she is pretty. She knows a lot of what goes on in the shadows of this city. Yeah, things are a little slow, but I'm getting by. Having to lay off some of my kitchen help hurt my pride more than anything. Granny's a fireball. She and Sal opened the pizza place 7 to 8 years ago. And they've been fighting ever since. Sal's a big guy with an appetite for food, wine, and women. He comes by here most every day for lunch. Bardo comes in now and again. Usually orders a couple of steaks and a chocolate milk. His temper's as short as he is tall. And he's only got one oar in the water. A bad combination. Sorry, Mife. Can't help you. Rook's been robbed before, but he's never had anything really valuable taken. This is gonna set Rook back for a while. Too bad the cops have turned a blind eye. Rook told me about the bracelet, but I don't know anything. He was a strange one. He had a show on TV for a while, got pretty popular. Then he quit the show and went into business. He opened up a shop right up the street from here. I guess he wasn't a very good businessman. The shop went out of business within a couple of months, then Rusty just disappeared. I heard he'd made some enemies in the novelty trade.
Well, well, it's that a handsome PI Tex Murphy. Have you come to take me away?
How'd you guess?
You must have seen my white horse hitched to the railing out front.
Oh my, Mr. Murphy, you certainly know how to excite a girl.
Well, that's what I've been told. I almost got my own 900 number before getting into the PI biz.
Well, I certainly would have subscribed. What can I do for you, Mr. Sexy Voice? Rook is a tough old geezer. I've known him ever since we opened the Slice of Heaven back in the 32. But I can't... Chelsea is a nicer girl. Sal tries to flirt with her. I like Louie. He runs a nicer place, and I go over there and chat with him when the business... Well, I was hoping you'd get around to asking about me. I'm just a lonely, hot-blooded woman who needs the love of a good, strong man. Me and Sal got married too young, and it's been up and down ever since. I've had enough of his drinking and the womanizing, and I divorce him in a second, but he's got a couple of buddies who are top lawyers. If I had some hard evidence of his screwing around, I could divorce him and get a decent settlement. Ardo is an overgrown kid. He comes in here for the all-you-can-eat buffet, and I've got to kick him out every time. If I didn't, he'd eat everything we got. Can't help you, Tex. I heard that Rook's place got robbed. It scares me to death. There's so much crime in this part of the city. Sorry, I don't know anything about that. He was a weirdo who opened up a shop just down the street. That would have been a couple of years ago. The business went under in a hurry and the clown just disappeared.
These posters somehow survived the big war. They're bitter reminders of the past glory of this great city. This is the brand new electronic shop outlet, no pun intended. I won't be able to get inside the electronic shop until I get a membership card. On the top floor of this place is where I hang my hat. It's not much, but it's better than... Well, it's not much. The Golden Gate Hotel was once known as the Waldorf of the Pacific. Its halls are still sturdy, and the walls have worn well. But there's nobody living inside. These signs around here haven't been replaced in at least... Looks like someone's locked the door. The Acme Warehouse is the former Snow White dry cleaning building. Nobody's used this place in a while. All hell has broken loose since the government stopped requiring products to display those give a hoot. I heard this newspaper box got destroyed right after Chelsea opened her newsstand. Coincidence? These fire hydrants are commonly used by the locals to mark territory in front of their respective... Ardo Newpop is a gigantic goon who works at the front desk at the Golden Gate Motel. Ardo's no rocket scientist. In fact, he probably doesn't even know what a rocket scientist is.
My name's Tex, and I'm a PI. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Okay. I think I already seen this show before anyway.
Captain Wallaby, your favorite show?
It's my third favorite show. My favorite is the Inspector Burns Fire Safety Show.
You know, Ardo, Inspector Burns and I are really good friends.
You are? Wow! I'd do anything to meet Inspector Burns!
Yeah, old Burnsy's the best. You know, we always play a little game called 20 Questions. You want to play?
Okay. I can answer some questions, but first I have to put on my fire hat because Inspector Burns' fire safety show is going to be on pretty soon. I went to his pawn shop because I thought he would have Inspector Burns action figures, but he didn't, and I got mad at him, so he probably don't like me. Ooh, Chelsea is pretty cool, because she's got good magazines and stuff. That's where I bought my Inspector Burns fire safety manual. He's a nice guy, and I like to eat there because there's a TV. She's the lady who makes the best pizza. I eat at her pizza place all the time because I love it. I don't know what that is. I just want to be like my hero, Inspector Burns, because fire safety is very important. I don't know. I used to watch his TV show, and it was pretty good, but then it stopped. And then he opened a store down the street, and I used to go there and buy stuff, but then it closed.
Coit Tower was once a majestic landmark. The wiener stand on the patio at the base of Coit Tower made the best chili dog in town. No one's here right now, though, so I better check back later. Pre-approved electronic shop credit card application addressed to the previous occupant. Just needs to be signed, stamped, and mailed. Postal service has gotten much faster since the stamp price went to $10. I should get my credit card back tomorrow morning.
So, Murphy, have you come up with anything yet?
I've got some clues, but I need some more information from you.
I don't know anything. It was a beauty! Ah, encrusted with diamonds and rubies and inlaid with gold. It makes me mad as hell that someone will break into the shop. I have a hard enough time making ends meet.
Thank you.
What else can I help you with?
Oh, looks like Mr. Bum is home for the evening.
Yeah, what do you want?
Looks like you're busy drowning your troubles, my good man.
Well, Mr. High and Mighty, what are you, a preacher or something?
No, I'm just a man like you. Who's been down on his luck.
Look at me. I'm crying. Now what is it you want?
I just want to ask a few questions. First, did you see anything strange last night?
The strangest thing I've seen recently is you trying to get information from me for free, you schmuck. Oh no, not you again. Look, I'll warn you right now, I'm almost out of chocolate syrup, and I'm not in a good mood.
You know, I just might have something that would improve your ugly mood.
Is that so? Well, what? Well, that's not gonna cut it, punk. That's not gonna cut it, punk. Come on, that's crap!
These are empty jumbo-sized cans of Camel's Chunky Chocolate Soup. Oh, looks like... Wow, a recyclable paper can. Finally. These are empty. Well, this is a section of the Bay City Mirror. It's a weekly newsletter that covers local goings-on written by mutants for mutants. I'd subscribe if they had a comics page.
What can I get you?
You want to try a slice of my chocolate pie? I can get you a piece to go if you like.
Ever since the Crusade started up, the relations between Norns and mutants has gone to pot. I've had rocks thrown through my windows, graffiti sprayed on the bricks outside. There's not much I can do, though.
Isn't a good time for a social call, punk. If I don't get her fixed soon, I'll go insane! Dory me, fossil lot to do!
I don't make a practice of helping out addicts, but I think I've got something that will ease the pain.
Oh, hold out on me, man. If you've got something, let's have it. Heaven, you brought the ambrosia of life. Ask me anything you want. I saw someone prowling around the back of the pawn shop last night. It was so dark, I didn't get a good look at him, but I could tell he was huge. Probably 6'3 or 6'4, about 300 pounds. Wish I could help. I saw someone. Oh, don't. I stay out of politics. Sorry. Wish I could help. That big goon. He used to hassle me until I shared a quart of chocolate syrup with him. Now he lets me alone. The only time I ever see Sal is when he gets drunk and comes by to pick a fight. Then I kick his butt and send him on his way. I don't have much to do with her. They don't serve anything with chocolate. Nice guy. Good cook. Every National Feed a Bum Day, he brings me one of his award-winning chocolate pies. Ugh. I think Chelsea used to fancy me. Till she found out my only true love was chocolate. Damn near broke her heart. Brooke, he leaves me alone. Can't ask for more than that.
I wonder what all these garbage cans are doing around here. Hey, this door's just painted on. Hey, this door's just painted. Hey, this door's just painted on.
What now, Murphy?
I don't know anything about that.
Don't get me started. That movement is nothing but a hate machine.
The Civil War's on the horizon because we mutants can't sit around and take the discrimination anymore. Those crusading fools have started something too big to control. I don't know anything about... It was a beauty. It makes me mad as hell that someone will break...
What can I do for you, Tex? Oh, I remember Rusty. He had a kid show on TV when I was young. I hated the show. That clown makeup always scared me. The Crusade is big. I mean, much bigger than most people know. They have operatives all over, and then these huge sections of the norm population are joining. Well, they say it's a religion, but then they encourage the members to be violent and prejudiced towards others. Wish I could help you there, Tex.
I haven't seen Mac Malden since the Martian Memorandum case. I remember him as a surly, incompetent, fat-nosed cop. As I step into his office, I can see he's changed. His nose is even bigger.
Well, if it isn't Tex Murphy. I figured you'd be dead by now.
No, not yet. Actually, I'm working on a case.
Sure you are. Probably a case of cheap scotch.
Tell you what. Help me solve this case I'm working on and I'll buy you scotch. And not the cheap stuff.
Bribing a cop, Babe Murphy. Get out of here now and I might not bust you! Can't you find something better to...
No, because I really like to watch your face turn red.
Still the wise guy, eh, Murphy? It was great to see you. Now get lost!
Oh, come on. Remember the Martian Memorandum case? Hey, we made a swell team.
Yeah, those were the days. I don't get cases like that anymore. Things are harder now. The mayor's office is all over me again. You heard about the string of pawn shop robberies? We have no suspects, and I'm catching the heat for it.
Sounds like we might be looking for the same burglar. Let's compare notes, old buddy.
No chance, Murphy. I don't need you getting in my way. Go play detective somewhere else. Can't you find some...
No, because I...
Still the wise guy.
Oh, come...
Yeah, those were the mayor's...
So you and your crack team of detectives have no leads?
Of course we have leads, you pots. We know he's a norm, Caucasian, and has AB negative blood. That narrows down our list of suspects to about a million. Now get out of my hair. I got work to do.
This piece of art is called Two Whales on a Bender.
Can't you find-
No.
Oh, yeah, the mayor's-
So you and your crack team of detectives have no leads?
Of course we have leads, ya pot. We know he's a norm, Caucasian, and has AB negative blood. That narrows down our list of suspects to about a million. Now get out of my hair, I got work to do.
Away. I saw someone prowling around the back of the pawn shop last night. So dark, I didn't get a good look at him, but I could tell he was huge. Probably 6'3 or 6'4, about 300 pounds. Oh, sorry. I stayed. Wish I could.
I don't usually... Whoever uses these garbage cans is...
Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not gonna work. It's all locked up. The only way I'm gonna get inside is by using my innate cleverness or ingenuity, or maybe a key. Well, that's not gonna. Looks like someone's locked the door. Well, that's not gonna work. I heard that Ardo shuts the place down every once in a while to do fire safety upgrades. Maybe he's painting fire extinguishers in all the rooms. Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not gonna work. That's not gonna work.
What can I do for you?
Judas Murphy, can't you find something else to do? It makes me mad as hell that someone will break into the
Hey. Well, that's not good. This is the brand new. I won't be able to get inside. Well, that's not gonna. It's all locked up. The only way I'm gonna get inside is by using my innate cleverness or ingenuity, or maybe a key. Looks like someone's locked the door. Looks like someone's locked the door. Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not. The Bijou Theater used to.
Coit Tower was once a majestic landmark. The Wiener stand on... Surprisingly, the Otto post box has no graffiti on it.
What can I get for you, handsome?
I think your sauce might be a little too rich for me. I just want to ask a...
He was a weirdo who opened up a shop just down the street. That would have been a couple of years ago. The business went under in a hurry and the clown just disappeared. Me and Sam... That's that religion for norms only? It makes me sick! Sorry. Ask me about something else.
Louis Lament runs the brew in... Nothing.
My phonograph's an old family heirloom. I love to play.
Coit Tower was once a... These fire hydrants... I heard this news... The Golden Gate Hotel was once known as... I heard that Ardo shuts the place down every once in a while to do... Well, that's not gonna work. I like to stand by these, waiting for a glimpse of Rita. Wow, a recyclable paper can. Finally, a glimmer of ecological responsibility. Wow, a recyclable paper. Well, that's not gonna work. 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 I wonder what all these garbage cans are doing around here. Feels like somebody's. These disgusting piles. The slice of heaven has been making pizza on the other side of this wall for so long, the bricks smell faintly of extra cheese. The slice of heaven has been making pizza on the other side. Looks like someone's back door opens onto the fire escape. Hey, this door's just painted on. Francesca Lucido makes the spiciest pizza in the city. These posters somehow survived the big war.
You look hungry.
Well, heck, that wouldn't be too hard with all the delicious food you have around.
Me and Sal got married.